Breaking news, SWAT teams with high-powered weapons swarming a local neighborhood after a report of a man with a gun inside a home. Good evening, I'm Mike Dardis.
And good evening to you, I'm Cherie Palello. People who live nearby were told to stay inside and turn their lights off. WLWT News host Jackie Conjato is live in Taylor Mill, Kentucky, where we've now learned the standoff just ended moments ago. Jackie.
Mike and Cherie, that's right. We got the all clear from the Taylor Mill police chief about 10 minutes ago. This is here on Janet Drive where SWAT crews were called in. It actually ended, though, according to the chief, in a pretty unusual way. We want to take you back to the beginning, show you some video when we first got here. The police chief tells us that they got the call just before 8 o'clock this evening, and it initially came in from a home on this street as someone who had broken into a home and put the homeowner at gunpoint, made him go to his knees and put a gun to his head. The homeowner called police. He ran to a neighbor's house and called police and indicated to police that this man may still be inside his home. Now, the chief tells me about an hour later, that man who they say is in his 70s, his son arrived, and his son indicated that his father suffers from some dementia. So at that point, police started looking into whether or not this may be accurate, whether or not there actually was someone inside the house. Of course, they had already called SWAT out here. They had to check everything out. It turns out in the end, they were able to search the house. They never made contact with anybody inside, and at this point, they do not think there ever really truly was a gunman here. But this tied up the neighborhood for the better part of 4 hours tonight. As you mentioned, reverse 911 call went out to neighbors telling them to shelter in place. We talked with one neighbor who took some video actually of what was going on his street. This was a very scary situation for him.
It wasn't until, I want to say close to 9, maybe a little after, that the SWAT team showed up and, you know, their van pulled up and they started unloading and getting ready. And, you know, for, you know, me in my house, I have three small children in my house. So, you know, for me, it's like, okay, well, what's going on now?
Again, the good news tonight, breaking just about 10 minutes ago, this has all wrapped up. Police now saying they do not think there was ever anyone armed with a gun, just a elderly man in his 70s who may have thought something happened. His son again telling police that he suffers from some dementia. I am told that he was taken to the hospital just to be treated for that. And at this point, it's all clear here on scene. Reporting live tonight, Jackie Conjato, WLWT News 5.